In a matter of weeks or even days, we could have a new 16-inch MacBook Pro and 14-inch models. However, there could be an M2 Pro and a big M2 Max chipset change in the processing die with this latest report. So, with this, I'm going to give the latest of everything we know so far, including the 16-inch MacBook Pro release date and price and specs summary.
So every MacBook now has an Apple Silicon chipset inside it, and the last MacBooks to get this were the brand new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros with that M1 Pro and M1 Max chipset inside. Now already a lot of us are wondering, what will the next generation Mac Pro give us in the likes of 2022 or 2023? Well, in this video, I'm going to cover over everything we know so far for the brand new higher spec MacBook Pros that Apple will release in the future. So let's get started with the main details of the brand new
16-inch MacBook Pro. Well, we've now had the introduction of the M2 chipset, and now that's inside the brand new MacBook Pro M2 and also that brand new design MacBook Air with an M2 chipset. However, in this video,
I'm going to cover over everything we know so far for the brand new higher spec MacBook Pros that Apple will release in the future. So if you watch some of my videos already, you will know I'm going to give you the latest details from specific reports of info that we've been told, then the details of the planned release date, then a summary of the models that are going to be released with all the features that we have learnt in previous leaks as well. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the next generation MacBook Pro. Also, put in the comments below of what features you would love to see in the MacBook Pros, and maybe in my next video, I will feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So, let's get started with this report that the new M2 Pro and the M2 Max MacBook Pros are coming in 2022. So, according to Mark Gurman, who's one of the most reliable leakers out there for Apple leaks, he has claimed that Apple are well into production with the creation of the M2 Pro and the M2 Max chipsets. He has mentioned, though, it's possible that we could see the new MacBook Pros this year with those new chipsets on a 5-nanometer die process. However, the architecture will be different to the likes of the M1 Pro and the M2 Max, and we'll see additional cores too. But what power boost do we expect to see in the M2 Pro and the M2 Max? The M1 Pro and M1 Max has given us a true generation leap in performance, what we had in the likes of, say, a 16-inch MacBook Pro with an Intel chipset. The CPU performance in both the 10-core M1 Pro and M1 Max is over double of the highest spec Intel i9 chipset in the 16-inch MacBook Pro that came out in 2019. But we're all wondering now, what will the new M2 Pro and the M2 Max give us? Well, we've recently had a report talking about the M2 Max, and it looks like some additional cores are going to be going inside it. So from the CPU side of things, we're going to be getting 12 cores instead of 8. Now, what this basically means is that it's going to be an additional 2 cores for the M2 Max. We don't actually know if we're going to get 2 additional cores for the M2 Pro. But most likely what we'll be getting is 2 efficiency cores, and we'll also have a total of 10 performance cores inside the brand new M2 Max, and that will give us at least a 20% increase in performance just with these 2 additional cores. However, like every other chipset manufacturer out there, they improve on their actual architecture, and probably most likely with these 2 additional cores and with Apple tinkering around with the actual chipset as well, we're probably more likely going to get a boost between 30 to 45% more power than what we have in the current M1 Max. We've also been told for GPU cores in the M2 Max that we're probably going to be getting a few more, so this will probably be 4 to 6 more cores again, but most likely with these extra cores and again Apple tinkering it around, we're probably going to be getting 30 to 45% more graphical power than we currently have.
When you think about this, this also makes sense, as the normal M2 chipset was near a 20% increase in CPU power and around about a 30% increase in GPU power, like what we just saw at WWDC. This is super exciting news to hear, as already mentioned, the M1 Pro and the M1 Max, and basically they are the top notebook chipset out there, and yet Apple are still aiming to push them even further.
I also want to comment at this stage into the video that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof they will come true with the new MacBooks. Like I have said before in many of my other videos, I can only present to you what has been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the new MacBooks anyway. So the next question is on the release date.
So with Apple's journey complete with equipping every Mac with an Apple Silicon M1 variant chipset inside, apart from the Mac Pro, but that's not likely to get an M1 variant chipset, but we have now started the M2 journey. It's very likely that these chipsets and devices will get replaced in the order or similar order to what they came out in. So I'm talking about an initial M2 first chipset and all the devices to be updated with that, then the M2 Pro and the M2 Max, and then the M2 Ultra. So with this in mind, we have the new M2 MacBook Pro, and we also have that brand new design MacBook Air with the M2 chipset. The next Mac to be upgraded with an M2 chipset is the Mac Mini and the iMac, before any devices that will get an M2 Pro or the M2 Max. This means that the M2 Pro and the M2 Max will be coming out after all these products getting an M2 chipset. So it's expected that some of these remainder devices to get that M2 chipset will be getting them this fall.
As I have said though before, if we do get the 5nm M2 Pro and the M2 Max chipsets, there is a possibility we could see the new M2 Pro and the M2 Max before the end of 2022. And that would mean most likely the new MacBook Pros are coming this fall, but as we know already, this is not the iPhone 14 and the Apple Watch 8 far out event. However, it is still possible to say at this stage, like the M1 MacBook Pro and also the MacBook Air M1, going over to the M2 chipset, that actually took 18 months to be upgraded. And this may still happen with the M2 Pro and the M2 Max. And that would lead that we wouldn't be getting the new MacBook Pros until at least spring 2023. But as more news comes in over the next few weeks, it will firm when the new updates to the MacBook Pros are definitely coming.
So, just quickly guys, if you didn't know already, this channel just got over 450,000 subscribers, and I recently did a giveaway of a brand new MacBook Pro 14-inch M1 Pro, and if you want to see who the winner was at, make sure you check out the video on my channel, because I announced who the winner was. But the great thing is, guys, I've got another giveaway. And because we're approaching 500,000 subscribers, and this is a big number, I'm doing an extra special giveaway. This time, guys, I'm going to be giving away an iPhone 14 Pro Max, and it's a 256GB model in deep purple. Not only this, I'm also going to be giving away a MacBook Air as well, and this is also the 10-core GPU option with also 256GB of storage and 16GB of RAM inside that. And not only this, guys, I'm also going to be giving away a MacBook Pro, another one, an M1 Pro, and this one has got the 8-core setup and also has 16GB of RAM and 512GB of storage. And I'm going to be giving away one of these prizes to three lucky winners. So they'll be picked at random, that one of you will get one of these random prizes, and basically there are three items to give away. And if you want to be in a chance to get one of these items in this big giveaway that I am doing, make sure in the comments below to write what Apple products, what technology products you're hoping to buy in 2022. Put them down in the comments below, and also at the same time as well, guys, I'll be announcing who the winner is of these three prizes and the three winners by a video, so make sure that you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell if you're brand new here, because you don't want to miss out on that video if you are the lucky person. One other quick note, guys, I've just got to say, there are lots of spammers and scammers out there telling you to WhatsApp them or to Telegram them, telling you that you've won a prize to PM them or direct message them. This is not me at all. You've heard from me. I will be making a video when we get over 500,000 subscribers, and only at that point. If you get any other messages, or if you're told to part with some money to win a prize, this is not me. Please do report these scammers straight away. And with that out of the way, guys, let's return back to the video.
With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far that previous leaks have painted a picture of what details the new MacBook Pros will give us with their baseline price as well. So the brand new MacBook Pro is 16 inch with the M2 Pro and M2 Max. So most likely we're going to be getting the same sort of design and very similar features. It's mainly going to be the chipset where the main changes we're going to see here. So we're going to be getting the 16.2 XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display, what is a ProMotion display, and that'll have a resolution of 3,456 by 2,234. And like I said, that'll be a ProMotion up to 120Hz display. We'll also probably get the same sort of storage configuration, so 512GB all the way up to 8TB of storage in the options available. Then we're probably going to be getting an M2 Pro and also the M2 Max with either a 10 or 12 core CPU, and we're probably going to be getting a 16 to 32 core GPU, but we may be getting additional few more cores in the M2 Max or the GPU. But then for RAM, we'll be getting the same configuration again of choices. So 16GB of RAM definitely for the M2 Pro. And then we'll be getting 32GB of RAM for either the M2 Pro and the M2 Max. And then 64GB of RAM option definitely for the M2 Max. The body will be an aluminium body again. And then we'll be getting the same ports we already have. So this is MagSafe. 3 USB, Thunderbolt 4 ports, HDMI 2.1, and an SD card slot. Then we'll also probably be getting maybe some slight enhancements to the center stage webcam, but this is most likely still going to be a 1080p camera. The actual battery life again on this MacBook Pro will be up to 22 hours as time. And most likely the reason behind this is possibly because Apple will probably be doing more efficiencies with their new generation of the M2 Pro and also the M2 Max. So basically battery life can be prolonged a little bit further. The prices though for the M2 10 core CPU option, and this will give you the 16 core as well option and also 16GB of RAM and 512GB of storage, so this is the smallest and cheapest 16 inch MacBook Pro, will be starting at the current price that we have right now of $2,499 for the base model of the 16 inch MacBook Pro with an M2 chipset. So that is a summary of the new MacBook Pros. However, for my thoughts and wishes, well, my thoughts and wishes are to do with actually the current M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBook Pros. I am hoping that when the new M2 Pro and Max comes out, that Apple still sells the M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBooks, but at a lower price. I am thinking something along the lines of what Apple do right now with iPhones. So each year when the new iPhone comes out, we still sell, or Apple still sell, a variant of the last generation or two of those models of the last generations for a bit less than what they were a year ago. I would love to see this happen to the M1 Pro and the M1 Max MacBook Pros, as they are such amazing devices and will be for many, many years to come. I would hope that the 14 inch base model, for example, would be reduced to say $1,799 compared to the M2 Pro base model that will be probably about the same at $1,999 that we pay right now for the current model. Do you think this would be a good idea? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below whether you agree with this or not. And also let me know what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Pros. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon.